It's been about 5 months, I think, since I last created an update video about 365. In 2018, we launched the company, and I came right out of the gate with a whole bunch of super ambitious goals about documenting and sharing and daily vlogging about our progress here with the company. But after a few months, reality sort of set in, and I ended up having to take a step back and focus on the actual day-to-day operations of running and building the company. That being said, the good news is the year was still a huge success in my eyes. We had a steady flow of work, we had great clients, we worked on fun and meaningful projects, got to travel the world, and we actually just made huge improvements to our actual production quality, which is what we do. The only downside to being so busy was that I wasn't able to share nearly as much of our progress as I would have liked to, but I do want to make it a huge priority this year to make sure that we capture and share as much of what we're up to as we possibly can for anyone who might like to follow along. So I don't want to waste too much more time here, and I'll just bring you up to speed on what we've been up to so far in the first 2 weeks of 2019. We just finished up a really cool ad that we created for our friends over at Oddfellows Barbershop with some help from our friends at Pro Skates. I'll post a link to that video in the description if you want to check that out. We're finishing up our highlight reel of the video that we shot in the fall for the Devour Food and Film Festival in Wolfville, Nova Scotia. We wrapped up our Puma video that we shot here in Halifax. Super excited for that to come out. Gavin created some wicked promo content for our friends at Sick Boy for their live show at Cineplex in Halifax with over 300 people. I was away and unfortunately missed it, but really excited for those guys and hope that they can do another one real soon. We finished up a promo video for an iconic brand, Alexander Keith's, here in Halifax. They have such a beautiful space, made our job really easy. We're wrapping up a series of short docs on some local artists that we created for CBC. And another project that I'm really excited about is one that we created in partnership with the SaltWire Network. They just launched the first video on their website. I'll post a link to that in the description as well. I also just got back from Germany a few days ago. It was my first time ever in Europe, so that was awesome. I was actually in a city called Nuremberg to shoot for Puma, and we were shooting some content around some shoes and clothes that are coming out in 2020, so I can't really share any of that video content yet, but I do want to talk about the experience as a whole. So the shoot took place in this big, beautiful production house called Pool House, and it was really my first time working with a full, real production team, meaning photographers, videographers, designers, models, makeup artists, stylists, producers, the whole deal. It was slightly intimidating at first, I'm not gonna lie. That being said, the team was so great to work with that everything went smoothly and it was a lot of fun. Sally, the awesome human who actually hired me to come to Germany and shoot, was nice enough to give me a tour of the Puma headquarters. I found it really cool to actually get to see behind the scenes how a company, one of the largest sportswear companies on the planet, actually operates. And one thing that I found extremely interesting was how they communicate their brand mission and values through design throughout the entire headquarters. The coolest thing though was getting to see their literal Hall of Fame with their history stemming all the way back past like 1948. Got to see signed spikes from people like Pele, Tommy Smith, Usain Bolt, and one of my new favorites, Romelu Lukaku. That was just really awesome to see. So the next day, after packing up and saying goodbye and thank you to everyone, I took a 3-hour train to Berlin, which was one of my top two cities on my bucket list in the world to see. So getting to check that off on a work trip was a dream come true. Extremely grateful. Checked out a bunch of the main spots to see in Berlin, like the Memorial to the Murdered Jews of Europe, the East Side Gallery, got to see a lot of the main buildings and sites, but I also got some great local recommendations on food, bars, and shopping. I got a tattoo right there, got a new haircut, and I also rented a bike and got to see and cover a lot of the city like that, which I always love to do, and that was a blast. All in all, the last 2 weeks and really the last 2 years have been a dream come true for me. So anytime I'm able to travel and meet new people and gain new experiences like that as part of what I do for a living, I'm just overwhelmed with gratitude. So I'm really excited to continue to share what we're up to here at 365. And I also just wanted to mention quickly that we are looking to hire someone, and we're always looking for new creatives to collaborate, work with, partner with. So we're not only looking for videographers, but we're looking for photographers, designers, social media experts, you name it. If you're interested, or if you know someone who might be interested, I'll put my email in the description. You can fire me a note. Anyway, I guess that's it for this week. So if you do want to follow along, be sure to hit the like and subscribe button. And if there's any specific types of updates that you guys would like to hear about what we're up to, be sure to leave a comment. I'd love to hear. Thanks for watching, and see you soon. So I'll kiss you goodbye.